can't jump up on my roof. Didn't face you, would've given you the moon. Even after everything that we've been through, I ain't never met nobody like you. Why you always trying to tell me that it's cool? Need to quiet. Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This clothing haul has been a long time coming. So some of these things you've probably seen on my Instagram already, because I've had them for a while. I just have been waiting to collect a bunch of things so I can do this like big summer haul, but I wasn't just gonna like leave them in my room and not wear them. Let's go. We're gonna start with Fashion Nova. I have four things from Fashion Nova. We're gonna talk about these jeans first because I posted them on my story and the back of the waist was huge. Like, they were so loose on my waist, but they fit so good on my legs. So I was super frustrated, but this is what they look like. They have rips in all the right places. I love how it's like open here. The fabric is amazing, like stretchy, like very, very comfortable. I think these are a six. I think I got six. Oh, they're just a medium. Yeah, so if I got a small, I feel like they'd be way too tight. But a girl sent me this video of how to make the waist smaller. So if you can tell, it's a little bit scrunched at the back because my mom helped me with this. But basically we cut little incisions here. I'll actually tag the video below so you don't have to listen to me describe it. But we basically just put an elastic band in the back of it so that now it's tighter on my waist. So it is a bit like bulky on the back, but I don't even care because I love these and I'm so happy that they actually fit my waist properly now. So thank you, mom, for helping me with that. That is the first item. Next, pair of shorts. Same freaking issue. So I actually really like the quality of these. They feel very like sturdy. They're stretchy, but they're thick because I have some from Pretty Little Thing that are like this and they're so freaking thin. These are thick. So I think these are medium also. Yep, medium. The waist is massive. Like, it's very big on the back for me, but it fits my quads so well. I honestly think I'm gonna keep them and like just deal with the waist being a little bit baggy because I'm just so into this like biker short, and these are like a little bit shorter than biker shorts. Like, they don't go all the way to your knee. I really like them. I'm scared to get a small. Like, I'm not usually a small in things on the bottom. I don't know. Maybe you could probably get a small because they're stretchy. I don't know. I think I'm just gonna stick with medium to play it safe because I don't want things to be too tight because then I can literally never wear them. And then the shirts. Okay, I love this shirt so much. I'm very much into these like tiny little spaghetti straps. I think they're very in right now, very cute, very summery, and it helps with great tan lines. So this is just this cute little crop. The only issue with this is it's not really that stretchy. Like, it's kind of almost like hard to pull over my head, but it fits really well. Like, it fits perfectly, stays up. It's not see-through, there's no nip slips. Love this. Only good things to say about this. And I got a size extra small. I honestly got this because I want to wear it to the Drake concert because I'm gonna go see Drake in September. A little bit of quality issues, but that's fine. So this is just this like little lacy bralette, and what I like about it is it has like extra pad, not like padding, but like extra thickness on the boob, so you can't really see through it. At least I hope you can't. I mean, you can kind of see through it, but I don't really care. It's black. You won't be able to see that much. And then it's just like a racer back, so it's not adjustable or anything. It's just like this one piece you pull over your head. And I got a size small in this. I think extra small would have been too small, so I'm glad I got a small. Now we're gonna move on to Pretty Little Thing. So I have three items here that were from a previous order that I had a while back, and I actually made a video about it, but I just didn't like the video. Like, I didn't like it. So I picked three of my favorite items from that haul that I never posted and put them in this video with these things. So some of these items are a little bit old, but, and the first of those being, which you've seen on my Instagram already, is these camo, what are these called? Biker shorts. First of all, I got these in two colors. Okay. The fabric is disgusting. I'm not gonna lie. It is literally the thinnest freaking fabric I've ever seen in my life. I just feel like you could probably get these at the dollar store. Like, that's just how cheap this fabric feels. It's really not nice. Now, Pretty Little Thing is a very cheap store. These were probably like $6 or something stupid. Like, so I guess you get what you pay for, but I got size 6 in both of these and they're a little bit big. Like, am I a size 4? I don't know, because I got everything in 6s and they're all a little bit baggy. Oh, good God. I cannot pull them up over my thighs. I can't. Like, look at this. I literally cannot get them over my quads. But like, there's just a lot of room from the top to the crotch. Like, no one's torso is that long. They fit my legs great. These ones aren't see-through. I feel like these ones would be see-through. I can't really tell when I'm wearing them, but like, honestly, this fabric is so freaking thin. I feel like these would rip so easily. I'm still gonna wear these. It's just, I'm kinda disappointed in the fabric quality and the stitching, apparently. Get what you pay for is all I'm gonna say. But the next little outfit I tried on was these two items. So I love the concept of these shorts. They're like very long biker shorts. They go like right to your knee. I don't understand this waistband. It's constantly like flipping inside out on me. I don't know why they didn't just like sew it in place, but whenever I pull them up at the back, it like flips up because they're way too loose on the back. Of course, everything's too loose on my freaking waist. I got a 6 in these. I love the fabric of these actually. It's very like silky, stretchy, feels really nice. It's thick. They're double lined, so you're not gonna see through them. They fit my legs. Again, loose on the waist, very long crotch. I don't know why biker shorts have such long crotches. It's so bizarre. I guess they're like extra high-waisted. And then this little top I got a while ago, but I thought I would throw it in this haul because I actually really like it. It's basically just like this basic bralette top. There's zero stretch to this fabric. Like, it does not move. So when you pull it over your head, you have to like squirm to get in it. Especially if you have lats like me. Yeah, I like the shape of the top. I like the like square neckline with the thin straps. I think that looks really nice. So this is just a cute little, shows a lot of skin summary thing. It is a little bit see-through. I think you can kind of see nips poking through, but it's a vibe, right? I wore this in one of my other YouTube videos that I posted when I went out on the weekend, and I love it. Like, I just love this. It's so nice. Like, it actually feels like good quality. The straps are stretchy, so if it's like too tight, it's fine because the straps stretch. This part of the fabric is not very stretchy, so gotta be careful with that, but it does fit me. It stays on, keeps my boobs in. Again, I have tiny boobs, so if you have big boobs, this is probably not gonna work because it's not stretchy. Same with that other one I just showed you. Like, you'll be busting out of it. The US size 2. Oh, I guess I should mention the one I'm wearing as well. Yes, hi. I quite like this. I really need to tan my underboobs to wear it because they're so freaking white, it's embarrassing. I don't really have much underboob to show at all. I really like this. I think it's cute. I like the back. It fits fine. Really nothing else to say about this shirt. I just like it. And then the other little black crop top I got from Pretty Little Thing is basically a freaking bra. I wish I sized up on this one. I got a US size 4. Wish I got a 6 or an 8, honestly, because this is so short. Like, it does not give you a lot of room for the girls to fit in there. Like, if you have big boobs, if you have anything over a B, this is not gonna fit you. Like, your boobs will fall out. So I was thinking to wear this, maybe you wear like a little bralette under it, even like a little black bralette with this, so that if you like move your arms, you don't accidentally flash the entire world. But it's still cute because you have like a little bralette, it's like lacy, and then you have this like thing over top. I feel like that would be so cute. So that's my plan if I ever decide to wear this in public. Okay, next top. I got this one a while ago too from Pretty Little Thing, but I needed to include it because I love it. So it's one of those off the shoulder tops. This fabric is amazing. This is probably my favorite fabric so far from Pretty Little Thing. It's just so silky. I think you can see a little bit of nip in this, but barely. Like, it's black, it doesn't really matter. A size 4 in this one. I like the length of the sleeves. They kind of like go onto my hand a little bit, which I like. Yet again, another biker short, size 6, too big on my waist. I love these. They're like this like shiny disco material. Like, why is the crotch this long? Like, why does it need to go all the way down to here? Hell, it doesn't make sense to me. So I tried to like roll this down a little bit to see if it would work in the video. I don't think it really works. I don't want to return the 6, order a 4, and then the 4 be too tight, you know? So I'm kind of stuck with these for now. Unfortunate. Has anyone ever ordered a 4 in any of these? Please let me know. Love the concept of these. Again, too big. Oh, my fucking waist. Now, next thing, I ordered this a while ago too, and it's a bikini, and it sucks, and I'm never gonna wear it, honestly. Like, I just don't like it. Love the pattern. I love cheetah. I love anything animal print, but it's so freaking stretchy and way too big on me. So I usually need a bigger bottom than top. So I got a US size 6 in the bottom, and it's way too big. Like, it is like loose on the back, loose on the front, will not stay up on me, just not a good time. And I just think the fabric is so flimsy. It doesn't even feel like a bathing suit material. It literally just feels like underwear. Like, it doesn't feel nice. The top is also too big on me. It's a size 2 and it's too big on me. The straps are too loose because there's nothing adjustable on this anywhere. Yeah, I honestly think I will probably never wear this in my life just because I have so many other good quality swimsuits that I prefer. Like, guys, don't go buying all that Zaful shit and like things that are so cheap because it's gonna last you like a freaking week, I swear to God. Like, it is so important to invest in quality swimwear. Now, I'm a little bit biased because I'm also launching my swimmer line next month, by the way, but I still truly believe that swimwear is not something you want to skimp on. I just don't trust these. Moving on from Pretty Little Thing, we are going to talk quickly about this one piece item from H&M. Okay, as you guys can tell, I'm clearly obsessed with biker shorts this year. It's very much my thing, very much my style. I just love how the biker shorts look. Your butt doesn't fall at the bottom. I'm so happy they're in. So these like Bermuda short things. So these are H&M. They're not as high-waisted as I like. They're like tiny bit below where I'd want them to be. Like, they go right to my belly button. I prefer above my belly button for high-waisted, but I really do like these. Like, they fit my legs perfectly. Plain black, kind of like washed. These are size 6 and they fit great. They're a teeny bit loose on the waist, but it doesn't bother me. It's like the looseness that you can't really tell if you're just looking at me. I love these. I just got these in store at H&M. I have 4 items from Urban Outfitters. So if you follow me on Instagram or YouTube, I guess, you'll know that I am obsessed with Lord of the Rings. When I saw this in the store, I literally started tearing up. I got so excited. Not much to say about this. I don't know how many people are gonna wanna buy it, but just this basic graphic tee of Lord of the Rings, the Two Towers, which is my favorite one out of all 3 of the movies. So I just had to buy it. Don't judge me. Next up is this friggin' adorable little crop top. Now, the fabric of this, like, this is why Urban Outfitters is so much more expensive than Pretty Little Thing / Fashion Nova, because when you feel this fabric compared to those ones, you're like, wow, this is so nice. Like, even the straps, they're basically just like these little elastics and they're so, so nice. This fabric is so soft, so stretchy. Like, sometimes it is really just better to invest in these like quality pieces that you feel really good in versus buying all these cheap things. I got size small. I probably could have done an extra small too, honestly. And the thing about these ones is they're a little bit longer than I like my crop tops to be. And then next, I kind of like to pair these things together, but I bought them separately. So first is just this like basic black bralette. It's like completely see-through, so you have to wear stuff on top of it, but that's all it is. Just this tiny little black bralette. I think it was on sale too, which is always good. All the Urban Outfitters stuff I got in store, by the way. And then over top of it, I like to put this little tie-up shirt. It has like a little collar, so it's very classy. I think this would be like a good little like out for dinner look. I don't know, I don't really have a life. I don't know why I spent $55 on this. Yeah, this is an extra small. I find it to be a little bit too loose at the back, so I'd have to wear it with something high-waisted and like tuck it in almost. I feel like that would be cute. Someone please take me out to dinner so I can wear this. Thanks. And that's everything. I didn't really have that much negative. Oh my God, I almost forgot the shoes. Hold up. So this is the first time I've ever ordered from Misguided. Might be the last, but so I honestly, these are the worst quality shoes I've ever felt in my life. I'm just gonna come right out and say it. I work closely with Closet Inc, so I get very high quality, like Nike, Adidas, good shoes. These just feel like they were made in about 10 minutes, very cheaply, not good materials, not good. So first of all, what the fuck, okay? On the website, this platform looked about this big, okay? Like, I need to go find the picture and compare because this is fucking massive. Like, they were half price, so I was like, fuck it. So Again, if someone wants to do a activity with me so I can actually wear these, let me know. Yeah, I got these because they look like knockoff Louis Vuittons. You know those like cool Louis Vuittons that have the like this shape going on? So these don't look bad. Like looking at them in the camera, they look totally fine, but like the quality of this is like actually disgusting. These are actually very comfortable. Like I'm not gonna lie, I don't mind these. They're just, if you look too closely, you can tell that they were literally made in about 3 minutes. So but I like them. I like the color. I like the fit. I got size 8 in both of these. I'm gonna stick with Closet Inc because I know that they're good quality. That brings me to my final items, my new Huaraches. Now the quality of these is something. I do have a 30% off code. Code only works on full price items, so keep that in mind because some people message me saying that the code isn't working. If something's already on discount, it's not, the code isn't gonna work. But it's 30% off and it's just Gabby Shea or Gabby Cheyenne. Oh my God, I don't remember. I'll put it on the screen and in the description box. It's always gonna be down there. And I don't get commission or anything. I don't get paid, just to let you know. But these are probably one of my favorite shoes. Just look at them. Oh, girl. If anyone knows any shoe cleaners, like good ones that I can buy, because these are all white and I'm already stressed and I'm gonna get them dirty, let me know, because I honestly don't know how to clean white shoes. So please comment below, help me, because I will cry if I get these dirty. Let me know if you guys enjoyed this video. I hope everything helped you out. None of this was sponsored, by the way. I spent all my own money, went hard. Okay, thanks for watching, guys.